I'm a toy collector, and I've been collecting for a good amount of years now, and I've collected lots of different toy lines, and they've warped in and out of this toy room, back and forth. Some I've kept, some I haven't. But yeah, there's a lot of toys to be collected out there. And you guys know my wife collects as well. Some people have deemed her collection room the pink room. Yeah, lots of toys, lots of girl toys. Barbies and Golden Girl, Garfield, you name it. It's a fun room, but yeah, toy collecting is fun. We enjoy it. But not everybody collects toys. I can remember when I was a kid, the two primary collections, old school collections, was collecting stamps and coins. And I know people still do that, but there's people that collect lots of different things. This is a bank that I picked up a couple of months ago. And upon looking into some information about it, I came to find out there are people out there that are really into collecting banks. Matter of fact, there's a lot of really cool banks that have come out over the years, especially from the company that made this one. We'll get into here in just a second. But a couple months ago, I found it. But I did originally see it maybe 4 or 5 years ago and thought it was really cool. But that's about the only attention I really gave to it until I came across it again and found out how cool this is. The company that made the bank is called Everlast Toys, and they were based out of Hong Kong. And I say they were, I believe they don't exist anymore. I can't find any information about if they're still out there or if they were absorbed by somebody else. But they did make a lot of different banks, and they were all wind-up banks and pretty neat. The one in front of you is made by Everlast Toys, and I actually had this one when I was a kid. It's this cash register that has this mouse on the side of it, and you press a button, or I think you put the quarter in it, and it would activate for the mouse to go around the track and then drop your coin into the back of the register. So I had that one. That thing was really cool. They also made this hamburger bank. I have no idea what this one does, but again, it does wind up. And there's an Apple bank, and then there's this robot bank they put out, and I believe this one is probably their most popular bank from what I found online. They also made an Ultraman bank, believe it or not. And one of the coolest banks they did is this one here called Creepy Coffin Bank. That is actually sort of still in production today by a company called Westminster. But Everlast Toys were the original ones to make it, and maybe you can find a vintage one out there somewhere or maybe online. And here is the box for the Castle Saving Bank, item number 550. Caution, not recommended for children under five years old. I can't read anymore. But cool box, it's just a photo of the actual bank. I wish it was a drawing, but that's okay. But this is Castle Savings Bank. As you spin around, there is a bit of a drawing, which is cool. Castle of Horror Saving Bank. It says wind up action, skeletal head tower rise and coin slip into castle. All right, so that's some odd grammar going on there. Turn the bottom cover out for coins gathering. Okay, again, weird, but okay. And here's the back, it's the same thing again. And we have the same thing on this side. And the top does say Castle of Horror. That's right. What does this say? Castle of Horror on the sign. Neat. And then the bottom is the same thing. And on the inside of this bank, there was a message that came with it for the buyer back in the day that says, you must notice before winding. You must notice. I love the grammar. Basically telling you that the bank was already wound up fully. You don't need to wind it anymore. So that's, at least they told you. I would rather them not have wound up any of the banks because it just mess up the mechanism. So go ahead, switch out to the castle. Boom. There it is. And we'll get some fun things going on with this bank. But it is casted in a blue plastic. I wish it had been gray, but that's okay. I think the blue's still cool. It's got some neat stickers on, a couple stickers. But I think overall, the sculpt that they did for it, if you want to call it a sculpt, it's pretty cool. And I can't wait to put some little guys with it. Here's the wind-up mechanism over here. And I do not keep it wound up because it's old and it does still work. It's really neat. I wish it had a light in it. I wish it lit up, but it doesn't. You guys will see it here work in just a second. There it is. So classic. Let's get a closer look.
It's got that family crest above the door. I have no idea what that crest means. Maybe it was made up. As you can see, there are doors there that they don't open. Then there's a spot here where you're going to put the coin right down over here. And there's the official sticker, Castle of Horror. This. Not bad. And I love this thing. I'm going to put some minifigures with this guy right now. I've got a few figures just to kind of dress it up a little bit. I found these online. Rather, my wife did. She bought them for me for Christmas. A whole tube of these things some time ago. I'm only going to put a few of them out. There's about 8 or 9 figures in this set. And say, hey, you got to do a video on these guys too. Maybe one day. But there you go. Dress up your Castle of Horror, your bank, with some neat little minifigures. So why don't we give this a shot and see how well this bank works? It still does work, and I'll do it a couple times. I'll even give you a little slow motion look at the skull. He does pop out from the top over here. I didn't give you guys a quick shot at the top. There you go. There he is. And that's where he comes out. So let's change up the look here. Give us a little bit of space and see how it's going to work. So I'll give it a couple turns. I'll put a coin on it. And it does have some issues, guys, because it's old. This spot right here where the coin goes is probably going to stick up when it's done. But you'll see the skull will pop up really fast. And I guess it's okay. So coin there. It does say to place coin here, it says on top there. So here we go. Hey, I should. There he is. Anyway, I'm gonna go do this a little bit more. Let's get this guy. Oh my god. Well, let's just let him go. He's let's try. Come on. Will he stay? We want it to do what it's supposed to do, right? But you saw the skull. He's fun. Do it again. So this lifts up the drawbridge here, and your money goes down into the pit of despair. There it goes. You saw that. All right. Let's get some slow motion on this bank. Some slow motion. So much fun with this bank. Hope you enjoyed that slow motion of seeing the skull. Gotta slow it down, you're not gonna see the guy. But pretty neat little piece. This company made some nice stuff. So go online and look up, again, Everlast Toys. And you'll find some more items. So I know they did make wind-up toys. There's a helicopter and a space shuttle that I saw. But they did quite a bit of different, as you can see, the drawbridge is still up. It's okay. But they made quite a bit of different toys from what I understand. But still cool. But happy to have this. It's going to look great with my collection. And maybe you guys can find one of these in working condition with the box online sometime soon.
All right, guys, that's the end of this video. If you enjoyed taking a look at this Everlast Toys bank called the Castle of Horror with a pop-up skull. So cool. And it will fit right in with my collection here in the Toy Room of Insanity. Leave a comment down below and let me know what you guys think about this bank. Maybe some other banks you had when you were a kid, or maybe banks you still have today. Check me out here on YouTube. Subscribe to me now if you haven't done it yet. Also, links down below for me on Facebook and Instagram. Maybe even Twitter if you want to go there. All right, guys, as always, don't stop collecting and have a great day.